Praise the Lord. Welcome to our midweek Bible study. We're glad you're all here. We welcome those of you who are online viewing our Bible study. Let's open our Bibles to Matthew chapter 8. Matthew chapter 8. And we'll read the first three verses. Verse 1, when Jesus was come down from the mountain, great multitudes followed him. And behold, there came a leper and worshipped him, saying, Lord, if thou wilt, thou canst make me clean. Verse 3, and Jesus put forth his hand and touched him, saying, I will, be thou clean. And immediately his leprosy was cleansed. Now, leprosy was different in Bible days than what it is today. When someone had leprosy in Bible days, they were declared unclean and could not come out in public. But notice here, Jesus was not afraid to lay his hand upon the leper, was he? He wasn't afraid that he might get leprosy. No, Jesus believed that what was on him was greater than the leprosy is on the leper. Can you say amen to that? Now then, it says that this leper came to Jesus and worshiped him and said, Lord, if thou wilt, thou canst make me clean. So notice here that this leper knew that Jesus, because of his connection to God, could make him clean. He knew that. But as what he doubted was not God's ability, he doubted God's willingness, didn't he? The leper said, I know that you can make me clean, but I'm just not sure if you will. So in other words, this leper knew that Jesus, because of his relationship with God, could make something happen for him, and that he could be cleansed and healed and made whole from this leprosy, but he just was not convinced that he would. He knew that he could, but he wasn't convinced that he would. And that's where a lot of Christians are at today. They know that God can heal them. They know he has the ability, but they just aren't sure if he will do it for them. Now, why is this important? Well, I'll tell you why it's important. Because faith begins where the will of God is known. You cannot use your faith for something if you aren't convinced that it's God's will for you to have it. Otherwise, your faith's going to be wavering because you aren't sure if it's God's will. And so that's why it's important to find out what the Word says about something. And if the Word says that it's God's will for you to have something, then you exercise faith to receive it. Amen? And so that's why we must know what the Word of God says where healing is concerned. I cannot believe God to receive healing for my body if I'm not absolutely convinced that it's God's will for me to be healed. But we see right here where Jesus answers that question. How do the Bible answers our questions? Find out what the Word of God says, and you'll have your question answered every single time. Amen. Praise the Lord. So we can see from this scripture here, from this section of scripture, Matthew 8 chapter, that healing is the will of God. Praise the Lord. Now, let's go to the book of Isaiah. It's in the Old Testament. Isaiah chapter 53. Isaiah chapter 53. And verse 4 says, surely he hath borne our griefs. Now, the Hebrew word there for griefs is sicknesses. So we can read that like this. Surely he hath borne our griefs and carried our sorrows. Now, the Hebrew word for sorrows there is pain. So we can read that like this by Bible interpretation. Surely he hath borne our sicknesses and carried our pain. Yet we did esteem him stricken, smitten of God, and afflicted. But he was wounded, verse 5, for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him, and with his stripes, we are healed. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. So, we see here in Isaiah chapter 53 that healing then is part of the atonement, isn't it? Healing's in the atonement. In other words, healing is something that belongs to us. It's not really even a promise per se. We say that there are healing promises, and that's fine to say that. But really, to be technical about it, healing really is not a promise per se. It's a provision. In other words, healing is something that's been provided for us. So, not only is healing the will of God for us, God has made provision for us to be healed. Hallelujah. I say, hallelujah. Healing is the will of God, and God has taken it one step further and has made provision for us to be healed. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I said, praise the Lord. Now let's go back to the Matthew's gospel again, the 8th chapter. We were there just a little while ago, just a little bit ago. Matthew chapter 8. This time, let's begin reading verse 14. It says, when Jesus was coming to Peter's house, he saw his wife's mother, that's his mother-in-law, laid and sick of a fever. And Jesus, it said, was afraid to get near her. Is that what it says? No. Jesus was afraid to touch her. That's not what it says, is it? No, it says, and Jesus touched her hand. And then what happened? And the fever left her. And she arose and ministered unto them, the rest of the house. Hallelujah. Glory to God. She, in other words, she waited on them. And when evening was come, they brought unto him many that were possessed with devils. We say demons today. And he cast out the spirits with his word and did what? And healed how many? Healed all that were sick. Now, why did he do this? Why did he do this? Verse 17 tells us. He did this so that it might be fulfilled, which is spoken by Isaiah the prophet, saying, himself took our infirmities and bare our sicknesses. So Jesus healed Peter's mother-in-law and cast out devils, or demons, we say today, and healed all that were sick in order to validate and substantiate what we just read in the book of Isaiah, where Isaiah said, we've been healed by his stripes. Hallelujah. Amen. So, healing then is part of the atonement. And this right here does away with the idea that Isaiah was talking about spiritual healing. No, couldn't be talking about spiritual healing, because our spirit was not sick. When you got born again, your spirit man was dead, not sick. Your spirit man didn't need to be healed. Your spirit man needed to be reborn. Regenerated. Amen. So Jesus here substantiated the fact that Isaiah was referring to physical healing when he said, we've been healed by his stripes. Can you say amen to that? Amen. Praise the Lord. So, healing not only is the will of God, God has made provision for us to be healed. We saw that in the Old Testament, didn't we? The book of Isaiah. And Jesus substantiated it right here when he healed Peter's mother-in-law and cast out devils or demons and healed all that were sick. Amen. He did this to validate and to substantiate what Isaiah said in Isaiah chapter 53, verses 4 and 5. Hallelujah. Amen. Now, it's obvious to me that Peter got a revelation of the healing power of God. Let's go to 1 Peter, please. 1 Peter. Chapter 1. I'm sorry, 1 Peter chapter 2. 1 Peter chapter 2. And let's read verse 24. We're in 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 24. It says, who his own self, talking about Jesus here now, who his own self bare our sins. Glad he did that. In his own body on the tree, that we be dead to sins, should live unto righteousness, by whose stripes, say by whose stripes, by whose stripes ye were healed. Well, were is past tense, isn't it? Huh? It is, isn't it? Now, are is present tense. You know, Isaiah said, with his stripes, we are healed. He's looking forward to the cross. But Peter here said, by whose stripes ye were healed. Well, were is past tense. So Peter here is looking back to the cross, right? Isaiah is looking forward to the cross. Peter's looking back to the cross. Well, if we were healed, then I am healed, right? Amen. Amen. Now, this scripture right here is the vaccination scripture I used to vaccinate me against COVID-19. The word works. I said the word works. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I said hallelujah. Hallelujah. And you can be vaccinated too by just claiming this scripture right here. You can be vaccinated against COVID-19. Amen. And all other viruses and all other sicknesses and all other diseases. Amen. Praise the Lord. I said, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Now, how many of you know that righteousness is not something that we achieve? Righteousness is something that we receive. Isn't that right? Let me ask you this question. Is salvation something that we have to achieve? Huh? Is salvation something that we have to achieve? No. Salvation is something that we receive. Right? What does Scripture say? Scripture says, by grace are ye saved through faith. So, righteousness is a free gift, the Bible says in the book of Romans, the 5th chapter and verse 17. It talks there about the free gift of righteousness. So righteousness is not something that's achieved. Righteousness is something that's received. Same as salvation. Salvation is not something that is achieved. It's something that is received. Well, guess what? Healing, same thing, is not something that's achieved. Healing is something that you believe you receive. Amen. So healing, like salvation, and like righteousness is something that has to be received. Amen. Just because the Word of God says that something belongs to you does not mean that you're going to experience it. You listen to me? How many know that the new birth belongs to every sinner? Now, are there sinners that will reject the new birth? Certainly. Why? Because the new birth has to be received. Isn't that right? God will not override our will. For somebody to get born again, they have to receive Jesus as your Lord and Savior. It's the only way to get born again. The only way to heaven is through the new birth. Amen? Praise God. Well, once someone gets saved, then there are rights and privileges that belong to us as believers. Healing is a covenant right. You have the right to be healed. We just found out tonight that healing is not only the will of God, healing is something that God's made provision for you to have. So healing belongs to you. So that means that I don't have to pray for my healing. I need to receive my healing. I didn't say it's wrong to pray, but you don't got to pray about something that already belongs to you. You can just go and receive it, can't you? So, righteousness is something that's received by faith. Salvation is something that is received by faith. Healing is something that's received by faith. You will not experience something that the Bible says belongs to you without receiving it by faith. Because the Bible says it is impossible to please God without faith. For he that cometh to God must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of them, or of those who diligently seek him. In other words, he's a rewarder of those who persist in believing his word. That's in Hebrews chapter 11 and verse 6. Now then, in order for someone to experience healing in their body, they have to receive it. They have to receive it. They have to receive it. Go with me to Mark chapter 11. This is our final scripture. Getting ready to close here. Mark chapter 11, verse 22. Jesus said, have faith in God. Verse 23. Verily I say unto you, whosoever shall say unto this mountain, be thou removed, and be thou cast into the sea, and shall not doubt in his heart, but shall believe that those things saith shall come to pass, he shall have whatsoever he saith. Verse 24, therefore I say unto you, what things soever you desire when you pray, believe that you receive them, and ye shall have them. Well, if someone desires healing, all they got to do is believe they receive it then. Isn't that right? Did you know that if someone doesn't even know that healing is in the atonement, and they come across Mark 11, 24, they can receive their healing by simply believing and acting on Mark 11, 24. If they're sick, you follow me? If they're sick and they desire healing, just simply believe they receive it and they shall have it. Isn't that simple? Don't be deceived by how simple this is. Amen. This morning, I got up out of bed, danced a little bit, shook that doubt and belief off, took my temperature, and I tested positive for faith. Amen. Hallelujah. I said hallelujah. Because I took my vaccination. You did? You got vaccinated? Yep. 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 24. That's my vaccination.